He wanted to come inside because you came. अलग ही नहीं कर रखा है
है
बहुत किया यार अच्छा अभी तो नेल्स करा दे उससे प्लीज बाग
अभी 5 मिनट मुझे छोड़ दे बस
और कुछ करना देख ले एक बार ना तेरे बेटे को कान काफी है
परफेक्ट एवरीथिंग इज परफेक्ट लीव हिम अलोन
फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम सीइंग योर क्लियर फेस
डॉग मॉम ड्यूटीज Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. If this is the first time you've come on my channel, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. And if you're new here, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button down below and join the Sarah squad. And also click on the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. For today, we are discussing something very out of the box, something that usually we don't see people talk about on the internet very openly, or something that a topic which is not tapped on very frequently over the internet, but this is, I think, very, very important, especially when I noticed that 97% of my audience is female. So I think it's high time that we start talking about these subjects. So if you're going to be uncomfortable with any of the topics that I bring on in this video, then I think you should put your earphones on so that this information is personally only for you. I think it's very important that every single girl who watches me, every single woman should know all of this. Another disclaimer that I think is important to put at the beginning of this video is that in no way am I an OB-GYN. None of the information I'm giving you is coming from a very professional point of view. I am a medical student, but I'm still in my final year, so my information is very limited. It comes from my limited knowledge of anatomy, physiology, but also comes from a lot of personal experience going to my gynec over the years, and also from my sister and my mom and everything that we've learned over the years. So if you have a proper pathological problem, I suggest that you do visit an OB-GYN. It's very important. But all of this that I'm mentioning is certain things, certain hacks, certain tricks that you need to keep in mind when it comes to your feminine hygiene. So with that being said, let's dive into today's video. Of this video, I'm not going to start by telling you all that you all should shower twice a day, or you all should use an antiperspirant or a body spray or a body mist. Wear fresh clothes, wear fresh undergarments every single time, wear fresh socks every single time. All of this is something that I think by now everybody should be practicing. So if you're not, please make sure that you are, so that you are fresh and healthy and the people around you find it comfortable to live with you. But keeping that aside, let's talk about the first topic that I have to discuss, and that is feet talk. Now, when it comes to women, we are more prone to urinary tract infections. You must have observed that whenever you go for a vacation and come back, or you're using a public toilet at school, college, or work, and often using a public toilet or a toilet that is shared by both men and women, you end up getting a lot of urinary tract infections. That is a lot of itching, burning sensation, a lot of discharge from down there. And there are a lot of reasons for that, but if I explain in very simple terms, that being that our urethra is very on the surface level, you know, so it is prone to more infections. We are prone to more infections than men when it comes to urinary tract infections. Now, certain things I want to mention are certain things you can put into practice in a daily routine that will help you prevent UTIs altogether. It's not going to guarantee that you will not get a urinary tract infection, and this is not something you should do if you've already acquired one. This is just something as a preventive measure, a general practice. The first thing that I feel you should do is if you're using water as in using a spout, or with mug if you're using water after you've finished peeing, then you should make sure that you're using a tissue paper or toilet roll and dabbing all the excess water after you're done peeing. What that does is that it does not let that excess water stay over there and not cause any bacterial infections. This is a practice that I started doing about more than 4 years back, and it has helped the number of UTIs I used to get drastically reduced. So all I do is take a toilet roll and keep it in my bag, or I just keep it in my bathroom at all times. Now, of course, in Western practice, they don't use water at all. They just use tissue paper to wipe down there once they're done peeing. But in India, we of course generally use water with a spout or a mug after we are done peeing. So after you're done doing that, just take a little bit of toilet paper or tissue roll, not too much because of course it's not good for the environment, and just dab any excess water that is in that area so that that excess water will not transfer onto your panties and not stay on your body for very long, which will cause a lot of moisture retention and therefore a lot of infection. Another thing is, if you're just using toilet paper to wipe after you're done peeing, you should not be wiping from rear to front. And from rear to front, I mean not from your butthole to to forwards, you know, you should wipe from front to rear, because if you're wiping from your butthole in forward, you're taking a lot of bacteria from your butthole and dragging it forward, which will again cause a lot of UTIs. So make sure that if you are only using your tissue paper or you're wiping, then you should wipe from front to back. Another thing that I want to mention is that if you're only using water and you're using water with a spout, like a spray, or after you're done peeing and you're putting a lot of pressure, like your spout comes with a lot of like pressure, the water comes out like really forcefully, and you're using a lot of water and pressure every single time you go to pee, it's going to cause a lot of damage to the flora around your vaginal region. Once again, if that good bacteria, that good protective layering around your vagina is disturbed, that is when it's sort of like, you know, you're making yourself more prone to infections because you're lowering your own protective layer around the vagina. So don't do that. Don't put a lot of water. Don't put water with a lot of pressure. Try to put just enough water that just takes away all the urine around your vaginal region, and then take a tissue paper and dab and you're good to go. The second thing that I want to mention is the type of panties you wear or the type of panties you use. Now, it's very advisable that you wear a cotton panty, or even if you're wearing a synthetic panty or a panty which is made out of rayon or nylon or any other material, at least the lining which covers your vagina should be made out of a double layer of cotton. That is not only because we get a lot of discharge on a daily basis, it's also more breathable, it's more comfortable. So if, like, you know, you get a veggie or something and it's like stuck inside and you can't really remove it, it's not going to cause a lot of abrasions in that area and give you a lot of rashes, which I'm sure happens a lot of times. So even if you want to wear like fancy panties, you can wear, like, I wear all these fancy panties which have these lace borders, but they are made of cotton and they are super comfortable. This is the one by Amante and it's super comfortable cotton. So the entire panty is made out of cotton, so it's very breathable material and it will not cause a lot of sweat collection or a lot of rashes and all of that happening down there. Now let's dive to the third point, and that is shaving your pubic hair. Now shaving your pubic hair is something very personal. I think it comes from a very personal point of view. If you want to do it, do it. If you don't want to do it, it's completely okay. I know there are a lot of like pros and cons to both shaving your pubic hair and not doing it, but I personally prefer shaving my pubic hair because I'm just not very comfortable being bushy down there. So shaving is something that's like least painful. It does not grow back any more than before. I know there are a lot of myths that shaving causes your hair to grow faster, and that doesn't really happen. It's just that it's taking the hair from the surface level and not like waxing, that it's taking it from the root level. So because of that, it grows at the same pace as before. So that's completely a myth that you should remove from your mind. And those who wax their pubic hair, I mean, oh my god, that takes another level of brave strength that God has not blessed me with. I will never get a bikini wax done. I mean, never say never, but I don't think I can get it done. But anyways, I try to shave at least once a month. So I just use a regular Gillette razor and I use a conditioner that I use on my hair. So I try to soak my hair really well when I'm bathing, and then like just use the conditioner so that it nicely becomes soft, and then take the razor and go over it. It takes a lot more effort to shave your pubic hair as compared to your body hair, because of course you grow a lot of hair down there. But make sure that you're not being like very harsh and not causing a lot of abrasions, especially when it comes to like your vulva region. Once again, go very slowly, very gently, so that you're not cutting yourself. This one I specifically like because it has this sort of a body that really well, like it molds into your curves and everything, you know, so it gets everything down there and you're nice and clean and spick and span. The fourth point that I want to discuss is discharge. Now, discharge is something that is very normal. I think all of us do experience discharge, but you need to be able to distinguish what kind of discharge needs to be reported to the doctor and what kind of discharge is normal. So if you get like just white discharge, which is not stinky, which is not burning, which is not having any foul smell, then that is okay. Usually you tend to get that before your period, so you tend to have a little bit of vaginal discharge before you're going to get your period. That is something that happens to me a lot, that if you're not comfortable with the kind of like wet feeling that you have over there, I just use an antibacterial powder like this. This is the Mycoderm C powder, which has been prescribed to me by my gynac itself. So it's a clotrimazole dusting powder, so it does a very good job of being able to soak all that excess wetness. But I don't advise that you use this a lot as well, because you're supposed to be nice and lubricated down there and you don't want to feel dry at all times. So if you're having a lot of discharge like all throughout the month, or if it's very stinky, foul, or if it's causing a lot of burning, that means you need to go to the doctor and get yourself tested, because you might possibly have an infection or something like that. It could be a fungal infection or, you know, something on those lines that needs medications, oral medications. In general, you can use this powder in your groins so that you're not sweating a lot, like on your long days in the summer, or in just like in Mumbai, it's always summer. On your long days when you're out there, you know, you can use this powder in and around that area so that you're not sweating and like feeling good and fresh down there. Now the fifth point is very, very important. It's a transition I made about more than a year back, and that is to stop using the chemical sanitary napkins we get, that's Stay Free and Whisper. I know for the longest time even I have used Stay Free Whisper. My mom has used it all her life, I know that. But the fact being that I used to get such horrible rashes, horrible, like bad, that I could not sit, that I could not stand, and I could not move because of the rashes I got by using Whisper and Stay Free. And I researched a lot about it and found out it's because of the chemicals that are present in the pad itself. They say that lock technology that converts it into gel form. But after reading all of that, I just stopped using sanitary pads altogether. I started using tampons, and I made that transition slowly and steadily into using tampons. Now tampons are something that are very, like, you know, people, I don't know, the Indian mentality has been very afraid of tampons, I feel, especially because of one myth that literally every friend asked me, that you have to be a virgin to be able to use a tampon. And that is a myth, you guys. Virginity is not determined by the intactness of your hymen. If your hymen is intact or not does not determine if you're virgin or not. Get it in your head, you guys. You're not going to always have an intact hymen. It must have broken when you were swimming, when you were a child, you know. You will never know. So that does not determine your virginity. And you can use a tampon if you're virgin or not virgin. So that does not hinder your usage of a tampon. You need to get that in your head. That is the first thing that literally everyone asks me when I say that you should use a tampon. And the second thing being that it can be very scary to like shove it up there, and what if like it gets lost and you never find it, and that doesn't happen, you guys. So I'm just going to quickly show you all the tampons that I use. These are the OB tampons. This is the Pro Comfort. I have like two sizes. This is for heavy flow and this is for regular flow. I'm going to quickly open and show you all what they look like. And this is basically all that is there to this. So this also causes so much less environmental damage, because every time you're using a sanitary napkin that is, I think, over, I used to use over 20-30 in one cycle. So that's a lot of garbage that I, one person, am creating for the environment. So sanitary napkins anyways create so much garbage, and it's just not good for the environment. So a tampon, I feel, creates a lot less garbage. Alright, so I'm just going to take the heavy flow one. This is how it is. Now all you have to do is take this string and just like flare out the ends. So once you do this, you have like this flared out end. You don't really have to touch your finger to the tampon at all. Okay, don't infect it in any way. Just take the string, do this, and once you've done that, take your forefinger, wrap it around this thread, put your index finger in this, hold it with your thumb, and then keep one leg on top of your bed or on top of your pot or something, and just like slide it inside. And just, you have to just exhale, relax, and slide it inside. Once the entire thing is inside, like this tip has to be inside, you don't have to be able to feel it at all. If you're feeling uncomfortable, if you're feeling abrasive, if you're feeling that you can feel the tampon, that means you've not put it incorrectly. You have to not be able to feel it at all. So just push it slowly inside, let it slide all the way through, and the string will be hanging down there. So every time I go to pee, I just change my tampon. It's as simple as that. Your first try is never going to be the most successful try, let me tell you that. The first time I used it, I was not comfortable and having a little bit of an issue, and so I thought, you know, this is not for me. But since I bought the full box, I had to go ahead and try one more time, and like second, third time, I was so comfortable that I never looked back. It just became a thing, and now I can never even think about using Whisper and going through that entire rash situation all over again. But the only issue is that you can't wear a tampon for more than 4 to 5 hours. Like maximum I wear it for 4 hours, nothing more than that. It's because it's going to not be able to absorb a lot of your blood and your fluid, you know, because it's only this much surface area. So it's not like a pad that's going to have a lot of absorbing capacity. So you have to change it out. You can't let that same toxic blood be in your body, so you have to change it out. So during the night time, I prefer not using a tampon. And even on my heavy days when I'm not going to have access to a bathroom at college or at any event or something like that, So then I don't prefer using a tampon. Then I go in for something like a biodegradable pad. And the one I use is by Sanfe. This is their organic biodegradable pads. So this is basically made out of bamboo fiber cotton. They have like two varieties in there. They have day and night pads both. So if you're really, really scared and you don't want to make that transition to a tampon, but also don't want to get those rashes from all the other pads that you get, so you can switch to something like this. It comes with this biodegradable bag as well. So I just keep this bag with me, and then after I'm done in the morning, I just put it in this bag and throw it in the bin. That is all you have to do. Of course, the day pads are much shorter as compared to the night pads. I mostly use the night ones, and these are like pretty long, so they have a very high absorbing capacity. There is no spillage whatsoever with these pads. Another thing is that it's 100% made out of cotton and it's organic. So it's not only completely environment friendly, but it's also very good because you're not going to have any rashes, infection, irritation down there, and it's very comfortable in general to wear and use. And this one box is for $300, which might seem expensive, but I definitely think it's worth the money because not only is it very comfortable, it doesn't give me the rashes and the pain I usually get on my period, and it's also very environment friendly. I would also like to thank Sanfe for sponsoring this part of today's video and for making the world a better place for women. Alright, heading on to the sixth point, and that is using a different type of a wash or a cleanser for your intimate area down there. The amount of times I said down there in this video. Anyways, the wash that I use is V-Wash because this is just what everyone in my house uses. This is very good, especially when you're on your period and you don't want to like put a lot of water, or just don't, I don't know how to emphasize, but don't use loofah and your soap and scrub down there. Oh my god, that's the worst thing to do down there. I can't even imagine. I know people do that. So if you're one of those, stop. Don't do that. Don't take loofah and the same soap that you're using on your body and scrub down there. Don't do that. Like when you're having a bath, just be in and around that area, but don't use the same soap in that area. You're disturbing the pH level of your... Another thing that I want to mention is that different types of washes work for different people, because there was one wash that my gynec had recommended to me. I don't remember the name, but that used to give me a lot of burning sensation. So make sure that you try and test. You do get testers of all of this. I had bought a tester of V-Wash before I went ahead and bought the full-size bottle, and this one works for me. So make sure you know what works for you. I don't use it on a daily basis, although you can, but I try to use it only on the days that I have discharge, or basically when I'm chumming and stuff. But yeah, with that, I close out today's video. This is all that I had to mention on this particular topic. These are practices that I have been following for years now, and have become a part of my routine, and I felt like a lot of people still don't know all of this, or still have a lot of myths about all of this and don't take proper care about themselves when it comes to all of this. I hope that you learned a lot from today's video. If you did, then don't forget to share this with all your other female friends so they get all the necessary information that they need as well. If you did actually like today's video, then please don't forget to hit the like button. Today's video, Sarah Squad shout out goes to Arya VS. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video, Sarah Squad shout out, then all you have to do is hit the subscribe button down below, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sarah Squad, and you'll get a chance to be a part of my next video, Sarah Squad Shoutout. Thank you so much you guys for watching. I will see you in another video very soon. Stay home, stay safe, and take care. Bye guys, love you all.